championship and college football immortality, a moment that every young football player grows up dreaming about. And these two teams have survived the expanded playoff grind. They have battled through a regular season, multiple playoff victories, all sorts of challenges and adversity, and they've arrived at this moment, the battle for that precious trophy. As we'll see, a squad from the SEC, the Texas Longhorns, taking on a team from the Big Ten, the Michigan Wolverines. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, joined here, as always, by Kirk Herbstreit. Kirk, everything has been building to this. It's time for the national championship. Let's crown a champion. Here we go with the kickoff. This is it, the ultimate game in college football, national championship at stake. He's going to return it from near the goal line. And he stopped at the 20, tried to make something happen, but that's good coverage there. The Texas Longhorns offense making their way on the field today. Well, here we go, Kirk. The energy in this place is tremendous. We are 60 minutes away from crowning a new national champion.
And think about it, Chris. These two teams have put everything into this to get to this stage and this opportunity. Let's see who can handle it better.
Solid gain there. Moves the ball up to the 32.
Well, Chris, with this style of RPO, the quarterback has to do a really good job of staying on that ride with the running back to make sure that the defense is really up against the run before he can pull it out and throw the football. Here, it's a little further downfield, but the same result as far as the potential and the big gain coming off of an RPO.
Facing a second and 10. Pre-snap motion from the receiver. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. That run moves the ball across the 35.
Boy, I'm a big fan of that jet sweep motion like that. It really forces the defense to stretch them out horizontally and can create some vertical seams for this offense. They got some positive yards, didn't quite get the first down, but I'll tell you what they've done. Planted a seed on this defense that they better defend this style of play moving forward.
Handoff here from the shotgun. Fighting for yardage, but the defense stops him just short of that first down marker. Longhorns will send the punt team onto the field. And the returner elects to fair catch it, no return. So the Michigan Wolverines offense makes their way onto the field for their first possession. Well, it's not easy to narrow down the impact players to just a few guys, Kirk, but what do you expect from them today?
Well, we got guys that can make plays as well as anybody in the country on both sides of the ball. That's why I think this matchup is so exciting. Two good teams with great individual players.
Well, they don't block the defensive end, who shows some quickness, Kirk, getting around the edge that time.
Yeah, this guy's usually getting around the edge to put pressure on the quarterback, but he reminds everybody here that this guy's a complete package. Not only can he pressure the quarterback, but also he is very, very talented and shows you the physicality he has against the run as well.
The defender gets a hand in there to break the pass up.
It is really tough on a quarterback when he thinks he's got a completion and an open man downfield. The ball's just about to get to his receiver, then out of nowhere, the defensive back steps in front of it and knocks away. Nice job.
They come to the line, a long way to go for the first down, but needing this crucial conversion right now. He's escaping the pocket now. And the junior decides to pick up the first down himself.
This is why I love the quarterbacks that can make things happen. Here you have an opportunity to try to create. Nothing's there, play breaks down. Instead of just throwing it away, he sits back, sees nothing downfield, decides to be able to pick up the first down by himself. Impressive run to pick up the first, keep his drive moving.
Scanning the field, it's Orji. He's moving out of the pocket. Quarterback on the move, trying to make something happen.
How about this by the quarterback? He takes a negative play and turns it into positive yards and slides down before taking a big shot. It's an excellent job of getting down to avoid that big hit.
Second down after that previous play.
Oh, a reverse.
Tackled way behind the line. He'll lose six there.
The defense there showed incredible discipline on the backside contain. And that reverse wasn't going anywhere. Just textbook.
They're backed up here, trying to make something happen on third and long. Here's the snap. Offense looking to throw the ball. Quarterback takes off now, looking to scramble. Slides to avoid the big hit.
This is a nice job here by this defense on third down. They take away all the options downfield, and they recognize the quarterback scramble. He almost comes up with his first down, but they keep him short to set up this fourth down.
The Wolverines will bring their punt team onto the field. Returner decides to fair catch this. Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. The last drive, they came up empty, had to kick it away. Can they come up with something here? He picks up nine, so just short of the first down, second and one.
Great job by the offensive line here, opening up some holes and giving the running back room to run on first down. Plays like this can open up the playbook for the play caller, allow him to make that defense think, are they going to run? Maybe play action, maybe throw the ball downfield.
Now it's second down here. And they're moving the receiver now before the snap. And they'll run it out of the shotgun. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
My gosh, this offensive line's got to do a better job of blocking. The defense was zero in on the ball carrier and absolutely nowhere to go for the offense.
So from the 28-yard line, it's a third and manageable here. Can he make it to the marker? They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Chris, that play just didn't have much of a chance at all from the snap. Quarterback hands this off and just nowhere to go. It's almost like the defense was anticipating the play call, and they put themselves in a position to come up with a nice tackle for a loss.
The Longhorns bring their punt team onto the field. We're going to kick it away for the second time. And here's the fair catch by the return man. And the Michigan offense comes back out on the field. They came up empty on the last possession, forced to punt it away. And they begin to click now. Play action here on first down. Going for a big play downfield. Oh, it's incomplete. Almost a disastrous play here on the opening drive. It's going to bring up second down.
It's pretty simple as a defensive coordinator. When a quarterback drops back to throw, if we get pressure on him, we got a chance to slow him down and win the football game. If we don't, could be a long afternoon. Good job here by dialing up the pressure.
Incompletion sets up a second down. Shotgun formation. Here's an inside give. Solid gain. Moves the ball to a 43.
I tell you, to be able to pick up a nice gain like that, those offensive linemen have to sustain their blocks. Gave them a chance at a really nice gain.
So now it's third and short from the 43. Can they keep the drive going or perhaps face a tough fourth down decision? Fighting for yardage, but the defense stops him just short of that first down marker.
Boy, this guy did everything that he could to try to get to that first down marker. It looks like he's just going to be inches short, and it's decision time for the offensive coordinator and head coach.
And the Wolverines will line up to punt it away. And he'll kick it away now for the second time. And this will be fair caught about the 15. And the Longhorns offense takes the field. They were held to a quick three and out last time, looking to put together a positive drive here. They're going to run it. And he's got it already past the first down marker. Solid gain there. Moves the ball out to the 32.
Every now and then, we see a really good run. We tend to focus on what other people did in order for that run to happen, what the offensive line did. Maybe the receivers are blocking good on the edge. Sometimes the running back is pretty good, too. And on that play, he picked up a lot of yards and made that happen with good effort.
Offense moving receivers around now before the snap. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Let's it go. Makes the catch downfield. Breaking through defenders. Tackle made quickly, but a big
receiver because he could be a monster today.
Longhorns hustle to the line to run the hurry up. The tight end goes in motion before the snap. It's a quick grab. Defense makes the stop after a 5-yard gain, so second and 5.
Love the timing here between the quarterback and his receiver. Pick up some positive yards, and I continue to be impressed with just the chemistry between these two.
Important second down play coming up. They'll try the ground game here with the running back. And they tackle him, but not before he picks up the first. So, Kirk, we reached the end of one. So far, a defensive stalemate here in the early stats illustrating the story. Getting set here now for the second period. Both offenses looking for some efficiency, for a spark after that opening. They'll try to run it in on first and goal. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of one.
Well, the back just had nowhere to go. How about the defensive line? They eat up all the blocks up front, freeing those linebackers up to be able to make the play. Just a bad play all around for this offense.
Ball back at the 10-yard line now for second and goal. Tailback tests the middle of the defense. That's a nice wrap up there by the junior.
And they get stopped here on second down. It's going to bring up a third and goal situation. And from this far back out, wouldn't be surprised to see them go through the air. Just don't want the quarterback to take a sack here. Make sure he gets the ball out of his hands quickly.
The offense has been moving backwards here. Now a long way to go on third and goal. And the wideout goes in motion. Third and goal. Looking to throw the ball. He's got it right near the end zone. And he scores. Touchdown, Longhorns.
Oh, just outstanding execution here by this offense. The offensive line gives the quarterback time, and the quarterback's anticipation was on point. Puts that ball right in the money. The receiver, all he had to do was turn and catch the ball for that touchdown.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. And it's 7-0 after the PAT. Now the kickoff team is out on the field. Return starts from inside the 5. They can't slow him down. And they've got the returner corralled. And the Michigan offense back out on the field. They're coming off a quick 3-and-out, so looking to put something together on this drive with a little more urgency. And the game moves the ball to the 20-yard line.
You know, a lot of people feel running backs with elite speed shy away from contact, but that wasn't the case there. Instead of running around the defender, this back elected to run right through him.
Second down after that run on the previous play. He'll hand it off. Stopped short the marker after just a short gain.
See, that's how you limit what an offense wants to do. This time, the defense just won the battle up front at the line of scrimmage, not giving up any big plays. Everybody's gap sound. It's really solid defense on that play.
That run sets up an important third down call for this offense. They'll try to run for the first down. The Wolverines looking to keep this drive rolling.
Well, it's a great job here by this offensive line and the running back to be able to pick up the first down. Let's face it, they've dug themselves a hole here in this first half. The only way they can get back into this game is converting on third down. It's exactly what they were able to do, get a new set of downs and a chance to put points on the board.
Trying to flex the ground game here. Running back takes the handoff. He's found some room.
more success they can have.
About time this offense gets going. It's a first and 10. Quick throw to the left side. He's got his man wide open. That's a big game before he goes out of bounds. It'll move the sticks more than enough for a first down. Hold on here a second. The replay booth has signaled they want to take another look at this one. Looks like they got the ruling on the field right the first time. They confirm it with the review. And they hand it off to the back. Offense getting set up. Here's second down. They'll run it here. Running back has the ball. And they'll stop him after a short gain. Now it's third and short from the 24. One of those line of scrimmage battles that could help decide this game. Dropping back, it's Orji. Running out of time in the pocket. It's a short completion to the big tight end. They'll stop him short. The completion gained 5 yards, but brings up fourth down. So a field goal attempt coming up now. And it sails right through the middle of the uprights. Solid kick.
Snap, the hold, the kick, everything there perfect to put 3 points up here for the offense.
Following the field goal, the kickoff team is out there now. Fields it just outside the goal line. And they stop him at the 23. That's solid coverage. Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. They scored a touchdown on the last possession. Let's see if this defense has been able to come up with some adjustments and stop him this time. And the senior able to make the stop after a short game.
Defense does a really nice job here of being able to contain that run game, held him just for 2 yards. Chris, to me, this changes the playbook a little bit now for the offense. The guy calling the plays at second and 8, that's a different deal. Now he's got to probably thinking about going through the air instead of staying on the ground.
Moving the receiver around pre-snap. Takes the handoff. It's Baxter. They'll stop him behind the line for a loss of 1.
That back just had nowhere to go. Got to give credit to the defense and their run fits on that play.
A tough situation for the offense. Third and long from their 25. Let's see if the defense brings some heat here. Looking to pass. It's yours. A sack in the play could not escape the pass rush.
Oh, my goodness. That looked to be the defensive back who came flying up there to put the pressure on the quarterback.
Longhorns will line up to kick it away. Offense goes backwards on this drive. He's on to punt it away now. And the returner is tackled by this punt coverage team. And the Wolverines offense is back on the field. They settled for a field goal last time out. They're looking for the end zone here, no doubt. Using the ground game here, tailback has the handoff. And he breaks the tackle on the way to a solid gain there.
Chris, it's pretty surreal to get to the national championship in this day and age of college football when everybody wants to spread you out and throw the football. This offense has been pounding the rock all year long. And here, how about in the first half? This back is having a big day.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Fakes the handoff, looking to throw.
so he does the right thing. Gets it underneath to that drag route and picks up a first down.
First down play call coming up. How aggressive will it be? Quarterback looking to connect with the receiver here. Short connection with a tight end here. And that stiff arm will help earn him the first down.
Chris, we get so caught up in these wide receivers and their playmaking ability and getting them the ball in space. Like the defense has to pay attention to them. Often too much attention opens up an underneath drag route like this. And quarterback makes a good read. Nice first down.
The Wolverines lining up here on first and 10. To throw, it's Orji. Looks to his left and makes the completion. But he's hammered by the linebacker. What a hit.
Well, that's the thing with this guy. You've got the ability to flex him out. He shows his versatility and what he can do from that slot position. He could be the quarterback safety blanket.
A completion sets up a second down play. There's the snap. They'll set up to throw. Pass ball is incomplete. There was a lot of contact. No penalty. Brings up third down. Empty set now. Five wide receivers. Gonna pick up the third and short through the air. And this one is caught. And the game just good enough for a first down.
The tight end drag route is the perfect option for an offense looking to scheme that position open for some yardage. Perfect execution here for a first down.
And the Wolverines are looking to take advantage of this red zone trip. Looking to throw it from the red zone. And he's going to fling it deep, going for it all here. Oh, and it's batted down by the defense. Great play to deny a touchdown.
Chris, that ball's tipped up into the air, and it's anybody's football. The defense, first of all, does a great job of anticipating a throw down in the red zone, and they're in great position to knock that ball up. But it was exciting to see, would anybody come up with it once it was in the air?
After the incompletion, QB tries it again on second and 10. Touchdown, Michigan. This quarterback on fire today. That's just nice execution. Quarterback and receiver Kirk perfectly in sync that time.
Yeah, you can see why route running is one of the most underrated attributes of a receiver. It's easy to get caught up on their ability to catch or their vertical or their speed, but nothing substitutes for someone who can create separation like this before the ball is even thrown.
Now the all-important extra point. And the PAT makes it 10-7. So the offense getting some momentum before halftime with the touchdown. Now they kick off in hopes the defense can get a quick stop. They'll return it from inside the five. And the coverage team pins him in and brings him down. And the Longhorns offense takes the field. Backed up this close to their end zone in the final minute. Let's see if they just decide to take care of the football and look toward the second half. But a huge collision blow delivered there by the linebacker.
Boy, that's pretty good coverage here by this defense. Not much of a window to throw this ball into, but the quarterback's accuracy and the size of the tight end picks up a nice gain.
Back to pass. It's Ewers. Quick throw to the left side. He pulls it in for a big gain. Take it down, but not before he makes the first down. And that will do it for the first half here. Kevin Connors now has our halftime update.
Chris, thanks. What else might we expect in a game of this magnitude? Everything on the line, the eyes of the sports world on this battle with the coveted gold trophy at stake. And it's been said football is a game of inches. And guess what? Based on the comparison between third down conversion rate today and the average yard per play, how can you argue that? I mean, the low-lying fruit is to look at some of the explosive plays we've seen and panic. But really, this game is going to come down to which team is more efficient when they have the ball and how they play when it matters most. And with that, let's send it back to Chris and Kirk in the booth. Fellas, hard to believe we're only one half away from crowning a national champion.
And he takes this from inside the five.
you know, the spread era over the years has always grown offensively, but what I've been always impressed with the defenses that really build their defense to play in space still have an ability to be sound at the line of scrimmage and defend a running game. It's exactly what we saw right there.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Quarterback drops back from the shotgun. Got him, he's sacked.
Well, let's face it, they dug themselves a hole in the first half, but I'll tell you what, they're coming out with a new look and a new energy here to start the second half.
Well, a serious challenge for this offense. You don't want to be in third and long inside your own 20. How much of a risk will they take to try to pick up this first down? This one's going to fall incomplete. Brings up fourth down.
Well, this is exactly what the defense talked about at halftime, coming up with a stop to start this second half. Now they've done that on this third down. We'll see what happens with the decision on fourth down, but the defense looks at a very different kind of energy to start the second half.
The Wolverines will line up to boot it away. And this drive moves backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Great move in the open field. And the coverage team makes the stop on this return. Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. This one has been a defensive stalemate. Let's see if the offense can get something going here. On first down, it's play action. Looking for his big tight end. Fired into a tight window and picked off. Can he take it all the way? Inside the 40. Not just the pick, but a big return sets up the offense in good position.
Oh, Chris, against zone coverage like that and the ball thrown deep down the middle of the field, you've got to layer that throw in. Very challenging throw, requires a nice touch with a strong arm, and the quarterback that time just did not make the throw.
This line getting set up, it's a first down play. It's more. Defense reacts quickly, a very short gain on the play.
Well, anytime an offensive coordinator calls a wide receiver screen, he's trying to get offensive linemen out in front of the receiver to create a wall so that receiver can pick a lane to run through. How about the defense here, though? That's called team pursuit and swarming to the football. They didn't give him any lanes, so not much yards downfield for the receiver.
Oh, what a move to break into the clear. And the runner steps out of bounds, but does have enough yardage to pick up the first down.
Look, I realize on any play call, when it's properly executed, it can go to the house for a touchdown. But the runs that really make a game plan work are the ones where you get just what you need. And he barely got the first down, but he got it.
Off the play fake, looking to throw on first down. And it's complete downfield. They finally tackle him at the 4. It's a solid gain on the pitch and catch.
You know, we talked this week with the offensive coordinator about what makes this receiver so special. He kept referring to his route running. Here's an example of that. Great route, enough separation to give the quarterback a nice lane to throw the football.
The Wolverines will line up here on first down and goal. First and goal, handoff. He powers into the end zone. Touchdown, Wolverines.
Here they just rely on the big boys up front to get a good push, get some tough yards to put 6 points up on the board.
See if they can convert the point after. And the extra point gives them a double-digit lead. Here's the kickoff team. Let's see if they give the returner an opportunity to bring this back. And here's the return from inside the 5. Solid job by the coverage team. They bring him down at the 16. And the Longhorns offense takes the field. Let's Let's see how this quarterback responds. Remember, an interception on the very first play of the last possession. Keep it on the ground. There's the handoff.
The defense coordinator this week all week telling us about gap integrity, not giving this running back any creases at all. Really sound defense on that play.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Pre-snap motion from the offense. Fakes the handoff here, looking to throw it. It's incomplete. He was hit as he threw that time. And now third down coming up.
Well, it's pretty simple. The defensive line does a great job of getting after the quarterback and forcing him into that incompletion.
Urgency now for the offense. They'd hate to come up empty on this drive, down multiple scores. And he'll drop back here on third down. And the junior able to get home with the sack. And the player is down injured after that last play. We'll take a timeout while they check him out. The Longhorns will have to kick it away. That's a rough drive for the offense. Punter comes on and booted away. So from his own end zone, he gets the kick away. And the fair catch signaled for and taken. And the Michigan offense back out on the field. Remember, last time they scored a touchdown. Can they keep clicking here? Or the defense come up with a stop? And they'll stop him short of the line to gain.
Hat on a hat up front. Good job opening up the holes. Anytime you can get positive yards on first down, that's a win.
Second down play coming up. Out of the shotgun, he hands it off. Already got the first down, but looking for more yardage. Brought down, but it's past the line to gain.
Boy, another nice gain by this back. He has had a beautiful day today running the football, just kind of in that zone, and a big reason why they have a nice lead today.
See what the call is on first and 10. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Fires it. He makes the grab. And he's run out after a big gain. The offense will be set up with a first down and goal.
What a pitch and catch by the quarterback and receiver for a big gain for this offense.
So two big plays in a row. The defense is reeling here. Now it's first and goal. Movement here from the tight end. Keep it on the ground on first and goal. And he runs it in for the score. Touchdown, Michigan.
I think we're starting to kind of see a theme here, Chris, today. That's his second touchdown. The offensive line doing their job, and he's doing an outstanding job of just reading the defense, finding the hole, and being able to pick up big yards and touchdowns.
So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. And the kick is up and good. They tack on a point to their lead. Here's the kickoff team now, set to boot this one away. Fields it inside the 5-yard line. And he stopped at the 20. Tried to make something happen, but that's good coverage there. Okay, the Texas offense comes back out on the field. They're coming off a 3-and-out, looking to produce a positive drive here. Off the play fake on first down. Throws to the tight end. And it's complete. What a grab by the receiver right near the sideline.
Nice play-action call here by this offensive coordinator. You can freeze those linebackers just for a split second. Usually that's going to give you enough room to be able to get that tight end behind them. And if a quarterback can make a nice tight throw like this, pick up some big yards.
On first and 10, they'll look to throw it. Running back grabs it on a screen.
Offenses all around the country have got to do a better job of keeping an eye on these little guys from the slot. They can dismantle a defense with their speed and quickness in the open space.
Getting set. Here's second down. Quick pass. Here comes a jet sweep. He'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
To me, Chris, with this offense, it's almost an extension of their running game. You put the receiver out in motion, you flip the ball out to him, out to the outside, let him do what he does best, which is use his instincts, and he picks up a first down.
Longhorns have first and 10 here. Dropping back, it's Ewers. Makes the throw across the middle of the field. And he's got his man open downfield. They bring him down, but the junior quarterback showing off the cannon.
That's another accurate throw by this quarterback. And Chris, when we did our prep to get ready for the national championship, we all knew that this quarterback potentially could have a big day. But I didn't expect him to get into this kind of zone. This guy cannot miss, just having one of those dream performances.
And he'll loft it to the end zone. Oh, and it's batted down by the defense. Great play to deny a touchdown.
Chris, that ball gets tipped and goes straight up into the air. That's anybody's ball. The defense does a really good job down in this area expecting the pass. The ball's in the air. Ball gets tipped. Keep in mind, the offense or the defense can get underneath that for a play, and the ball hits the ground for an incompletion.
Play action fake. Looking to throw. Junior steps up and makes an impact play.
Just outstanding combination of quickness and strength here by this Michigan defensive lineman. Makes me think of Aiden Hutchinson, who, of course, played here recently. Going back to guys like Rashawn Gary, Lamar Woodley, Frank Clark. Great tradition of Michigan defensive linemen on full display right now.
Third down. The offense desperately needs a conversion here, trailing in the third quarter. Here's the snap. Quarterback looking to throw. Looking to set up a screen pass here. Defense makes the stop. The screen pass doesn't produce a first down. And now it's fourth down.
Now there's just nothing here for the quarterback to do other than throw it to his back and hope that he could get the yards after the catch and up for the first down. But the defense gives some yards, but not enough for him to get to the sticks.
So on fourth down, the decision is to trot out the field goal team. And he knocks it right through the uprights.
I was watching this guy in pregame. He has got a strong leg. Not surprised here he's able to put 3 points up here for the offense.
So after coming away with three in that drive, the kickoff team is out. Return begins inside the 10. He'll be tackled at the 17. Strong job by the coverage team. And the Wolverines offense is back on the field. This group has been clicking. They've really built momentum. Can the defense make adjustments? Come up with a stop here. It's a solid gain. Moves the ball out to the 28.
Hey, whether it's been on the inside or bouncing things to the outside, this guy has shown you everything that he has to offer, and a big part of the reason why they're enjoying this nice lead.
Big guys up front lined up. It's first down. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Beautiful catch right near the sideline. Gets the foot down. First down play call. How aggressive will it be? Takes the handoff. It's Edwards. And the tackle is made on what's going to be the final play of this period. So, Kirk, Michigan has the lead here at the end of the quarter. We've reached the end of the third quarter, and the this national championship battle that has lived up to the hype. Before the final period, let's check out the game stats. Pretty good chance it's going to come down to the final possession. Which guy can step up and make plays as we head to the fourth quarter? To throw, it's Orji. Oh, they've got him for a sack. A big play made by the junior.
Good pressure here by this defense, but it felt like the quarterback held on to the ball a little bit too long to come up with that sack for the D.
Offense been in reverse here. Now a long way to go to convert this third down. There's the snap, and he's looking to throw. Caught behind the line. It's Moore. Defense able to stop him. It's fourth down now. And the Wolverines will line up to punt it away. Running it back, it's Bolden. The returner is brought down. There is a flag on the field, so we'll check out this call. Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. The Wolverines are going to keep this drive rolling. Here comes the handoff. Picks up two, so it's second and eight.
I like the run play here, and offensively at this point in the game, you want to remain in that attack mode first while also staying in bounds and working that clock.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Quarterback drops back. Grab behind the line, it's Edwards. Defense surrounds him, just a short gain on that completion.
Hey, it's a game, but you get the sense that this offense wanted a little bit more from that play.
And it's a bunch formation. Back to pass. It's Orji. And a short pitch and catch to the tight end. And they pick up the first down, tackle at the 25.
Well, the defense gets these guys to third down. They got a chance to get them off the field, and instead, they give up the first down. So the clock will continue to move, and the defense is really at the mercy of this offense at this point.
The Wolverines will have first and 10 here. They'll run it here. Has the first down and more. And he runs it into the end zone. Touchdown, Wolverines. That's another touchdown, a dream performance from this running back on the biggest possible stage.
I mean, Chris, we're talking about the national championship. This defense has had a lot of time to prepare. They've heard all about him. In fact, they told us the only chance we have to win this game is we've got to stop their ability to run the ball and stop their running back. So far, they are struggling.
Kicking team out for the PAT try. Extra point up and good. A 3-touchdown lead now here in the final quarter. And the head coach will decide to accept the penalty and take the yardage. Now they get set to kick it away. This one is not returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone. First down here for this offense. He'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Gets made on the out route. Then he'll run out of bounds after picking up a few yards on the play.
How about the job by this defense against this receiver? One of the top receivers in the country. They knew he was going to be able to be a big factor in this game, and they have kept him quiet all game long until right now. In the fourth quarter, he comes up with his first catch.
starts to bring pressure here. Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. It's an out route, the catch made. Ball carrier heads out of bounds, but the pickup is good enough to move the chains. First down.
This is a big conversion by this offense. They're down now in the second half. Probably limited opportunities at this point in the game. Every chance you get your hands on the ball, you need points. They keep this drive alive right here.
Looking to throw again. He's got it for a big gain. Brought down, it crosses midfield to the 46.
Chris, here we are in the fourth quarter. These guys are trailing. Had been a great day, but with this quarterback, he's as gifted as anybody in the country. You never count these guys out.
Longhorns will come to the line to run the hurry up. Caught in the backfield. It's Bolden. And the defense swarms. Not much of a gain on that completion.
I love what the defense is doing here. Sitting back, giving up some plays underneath, tackling these guys inbounds, and just keep that clock rolling.
Second down after that run on the previous play. Quarterback drops back. We're going to test the secondary. And he pulls in the catch. They bring him down, but an explosive play by this offense. Big game.
Finally, good for them. They come up with a big play like this. Let's face it. Offense has been at a premium for these guys. You wonder where plays like this have been all game long.
The Longhorns looking to cash in this red zone trip. From inside the red zone, they're looking to throw. He fires this throw and is intercepted. He's got some room and some blockers here. Past the 50. Out past the 30. It's a big return off the INT. They steal their offensive possession.
Just a great job of anticipating that and coming up with a big interception by this defense. Because they have this lead, they've really forced this offense to become one-dimensional. They're expecting the ball to be into the air. The defensive backs have their eyes on the ball, and they're able to capitalize with a big pick here in the national title.
And the Michigan offense comes back out on the field. They had a brilliant touchdown drive last time, mixing the run and the pass. Can they keep that going again? Zero running room. Stopped right at the line of scrimmage.
That's a great play all around by this defense. Your first-level defenders hold their own at the point of attack, allowing the second- and third-level players to roam free and make the tackle close to the line of scrimmage.
Second down play coming up for this offense. They'll work the clock here with the running game. He's wrapped up nicely there by the freshman.
You know, in the era that we live in right now, everybody wants to spread the field around, try to create space, try to create one-on-one matchups, and the defense is countered over the years by trying to play out wide. But here's a great example of a defense has the ability to play wide, but still be solid at the line of scrimmage and not give up big run plays.
Back to throw. It's Orgy. Quick throw over the middle. Touchdown, Michigan. And the beatdown continues. So they'll try to add to the lead now with a PAT. The extra point is good, and they stretch the lead a little bit more. Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. Kickoff team on the field getting set now. Long kickoff, no chance for a return. It'll be a touchback. Fresh set of downs for the offense. First down. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Deep ball is caught for a huge.
coach isn't content with giving up plays like that at any point in the game.
First down play call coming up. How aggressive will it be? They snap it. Quarterback looking to throw the ball. Looks downfield and finds a receiver who worked his way wide open. Out of bounds, but not before a huge gain. Offense gets a fresh set of downs. Well, this defense has played well with a letdown there. A little too comfortable with this big lead at the moment, maybe.
Yeah, and what I love to see is this offense has not given up. This game has not gone the way they had hoped, but here they are taking a few swings late in this game. This one ends up working out. And now let's see if they can put another play or two together and get the points on the board.
Makes a quick grab. Brought down, but the completion moves the ball inside the 10-yard line. Defense getting pushed back.
Hey, there's the execution that's been lacking most of this game, but they'll take it. You know, you try to do everything that you can to learn and try to build for the future. And at this point in the game, it's obviously over, but you love to see the offense coordinator still giving this quarterback opportunities.
Here's a target, and it's complete. They bring him down at the 7. The offense set up now with a first and goal. Made the catch, but he was surrounded. There was not much room to run.
They did a really good job that time of leveraging him out in space. I thought he might have a chance to be able to shake loose because he is so elusive. But defense, as you said, did a really good job in the open field surrounding him. Just nowhere for him to go to pick up any more positive yards.
Play action here on first down. Looking to the end zone. He's picked for a third time tonight. And he'll be taken down, but after a good return.
Oh, man, Chris, I really thought this offense had a chance to get back into this game. The only thing you'd hate to see is the interception. But give credit to the defense. They come up with a big play that potentially ices the game.
And the Michigan offense back out on the field. This has been a tremendous performance by this team. Now just the finishing touches. Run out the clock and let the party begin. Looking for some space. It's Edwards. They'll tackle him about the 15-yard line.
Just another example of this offense, Chris, doing pretty much whatever they want to do. They've been able to run the football. Offensive lines held their own in pass protection. Quarterbacks had an outstanding day. You add all that up, it's a big reason why they're up by such a wide margin.
Second down after that run on the